Australian authorities report a slowdown in new COVID-19 cases in Sydney on the heels of an extended lockdown. 65 new infections were recorded in Sydney Wednesday, a decrease from 97 a day earlier. The capital of New South Wales and one of Australia's largest cities will remain under lockdown until at least July 30th.
Whilst the case numbers are bouncing around, we are seeing a stabilisation. They are not growing exponentially. That tells us that the settings we have in place are having an impact. So my strongest message to everybody is keep doing what you are doing. Keep sticking to the rules because we are seeing the impact of that. But the next challenge for us is to see a drop in the numbers of people infectious in the community. We are seeing a level of stabilisation, but we need to see those numbers drop.
Over in the Australian state of Victoria, authorities are rushing to track the close contacts of several COVID-19 cases linked to Sydney's Delta variant outbreak. The state recorded 10 new cases Wednesday. They also identified dozens of venues in the city of Melbourne as virus-exposed locations. Myanmar suffers its most severe wave of COVID-19 infections so far. The military-ruled nation reported 7,089 new cases and 145 deaths on Wednesday, both fresh record highs. Efforts to contain the virus has been hampered by daily protests against the junta, with health workers joining the movement as well. A spokesman for the military says they are doing all they can to ramp up health services, even opening up military hospitals to the public. Over in Singapore, nearly 3,000 passengers and crew finally leave a cruise ship after a COVID-19 case left them stuck in the rooms through most of Wednesday. The patient, a 40-year-old passenger, tested positive on board, forcing the ship to dock earlier than planned. The results were confirmed after the person was taken to a hospital. Singapore's tourism board says the passenger was identified as a close contact of a confirmed case on land. Local media reported the case on the ship was part of a growing cluster of COVID-19 infections associated with karaoke lounges. Singapore recorded 56 locally transmitted cases on Wednesday, the highest number of domestic daily infections in 10 months.